that you've given us to come together and make decisions for the best path forward for this city. We also thank you for all the gifts that you have bestowed upon us and our city. And we just pray for wisdom tonight as we go forward with matters of or issues that we have tonight. In your name we pray. Amen.
Please place the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I talked to Brandon a couple weeks ago. We got our bull ride coming back up again in January. That's the 8th and 9th. And it's the PBR event again this year. And some of y'all know we do a special needs event on Thursday. And what that is we have a special needs rodeo for the special service centers of the county. And they have activities, pony rides, and just stuff for the kids to do because that's the only time they ever actually get a chance to get out. And then also this year we've included what we call an ABDI, this American Bucket Bull Incorporated. Generally y'all used to send my bull bucket to events. Well, what this does is other contractors raise bulls other than myself all across the country. And there'll be a 3-year-old and a 4-year-old event. These guys will bring in their best 3-year-olds and their best 4-year-olds. And the reason we're doing that is we can get anywhere from 35 to maybe 70 contractors. That'll come into the city, they'll be here from Thursday to Sunday. So they're gonna stay here, they're gonna eat, you know, spend a lot of money right here. It'll generate more revenue for the city. And which I'll still have some bulls here for the short round stuff, you know, so people that come watch my bulls. But I think us doing that, it'll help generate a little more revenue and help the ag center and help the city.
And you said by the ABVI, that is the same thing. The bulls actually get judged like the Cowboys do.
Yes.
So the same things like you see on TV or this and that, you're going to have the best of everything that's going to be here.
Instead of a 2-judge format, they use a 6-judge format. They do it just like the Olympics. They add all 6 up, multiply by 2, and divide by 4, something like that. And that's supposed to keep many ties. And, we try every year to make this venue bigger and bigger every year. We do it basically because of kids. I don't know if any of y'all have ever been here or not, but if you haven't, you need to come on Thursday. And Nick got to see it last year in Brandon, and those kids really enjoy it. And we're hoping by adding the ABBI being in with it, and to bring a lot of people into this town that ain't never been here. And the tickets will be like it was last year. They'll be $20.15 at the door, or $17 and $12 advanced. And also, the ABBI required me to have security on site Friday and Saturday night. So any off-duty police officer would like to work, have them get contact with me and we'll pay them. And all they have to do is sit out there in their personal vehicle, if they choose to, from 10 o'clock to 7 o'clock in the morning. Because these bulls that's coming in here, like this year, you know, the bull that won the year-end champion, he won over $500,000. And just like any other sport, people tamper with other people's animals. And no one can be on the premises out back. If they get caught, they're disqualified. First time an event like this has been approached about being brought into this area. And I talked with Jay at the office. The books ain't opened yet, so we don't know exactly how many contractors we're going to get. We don't know if we'll even get enough, but we're pushing real hard to make it work. That's about all it.
I know we're thankful for it because, like I said, my kids were here both nights because, like I said, mine love it. So, I mean, it's...
Well, that's the whole thing of the event, you know. We want everybody to enjoy it. We want the city, we want the event to come in, we want us to come back.
Exactly.
We don't want to come in and we don't want them folks back. A lot of people think bull riders are going to come in, hooping and hollering, tearing stuff up. These guys, as far as the PBR, these guys are professionals. They got sponsors, they do this for a living. Like the group that come in on Friday will catch a flight and head to Chicago for Saturday. And then vice versa, the ones that are up there will be coming here for Saturday. Also, the PBR this year, I don't know if you don't follow it or not, but the PBR just sold to IMG. IMG is the largest corporation in the world. And they've regulated events. We've got the only touring pro that weekend. like in the past, they'd have four or five. So I think we'll see a lot of really good bull riders.
And probably bigger crowds and stuff too, because you're the only one going on versus, like you said, four or five.
Well, that's up to the area. You know, I mean, I can't control who comes, you know. But,
right.
But, you know, get to see that caliber of contestants for that money, most folks have to go to like Atlanta
right.
and pay $100.
What kind of purse is it?
I didn't even think about it. I think it pays $6,000 for the winner of the bull ride. And for the bulls itself, now I know they don't need it. The winner of the bull for Thursday or Friday night will receive $6,000 in the buckle. And the same thing for Saturday. And one reason I want to tell y'all, you know, like when you come in, some people might get confused. You might hear a bull being called out on this contract tonight. And, you know, there'll be all the different contractors. And you'll see judges scattered out. And that's what they're doing. They're marking just the bulls. Like the Cowboys compete for money. Those contractors compete. And, which this is my passion too, because I'm gonna bring bulls I've raised, and actually I love them in my home, you know, hometown league.
Yeah.
Even though I live in Fife, this is closest to home, you know. I mean, most time we have to travel 12, 14 hours to one of these events. And it's like the next weekend after ours will be one in Fort Worth, and then one in Oklahoma City. So that's the closest home we get.
We appreciate it.
Thank you.
More than you know, we thank you.
Still, you know, still be looking at, of course, they're building this truck for Rainsville, so we'll still be looking at, you know, probably over 6 months away. But I'm okay with their recommendation. If y'all want to take some time and look through it, that's fine. Do you have any thoughts on that? All I guess is you know, basically, it went to your bleed personally, and not your staff.
You know. You had me a little bit.
He's also suggesting is tack it onto the list three part-time to use in the advantage of vacation or sick time, eliminate some overtime, and also looks like we're running into quite a bit of overtime in the dispatch, and he'd like to tack on to part-time. So he's here if you want to add anything to that, I've missed any points.
That sounds pretty good. You know, Pinder's going to be graduating from the academy soon this month, so if we go to night shift and we get that other officer hired in as soon as possible. I'm asking for a certified officer. I know that y'all have a list of posting for 7 days in-house and then the 14 days outhouse, if I'm not, is that correct? Well, I don't believe we have anybody that's a certified officer within the city of Rainsville that's not already at work at the police department as a patrolman. I would like to see if we could suspend the 7 days and go ahead and put in the 14-day one, if that's okay with y'all, to go ahead and see if we can't get this extra man hired as soon as possible, so that way we can go ahead and start running 3-0 nights. We've had some issues about during our shift change on calls. One of these guys, one of the night shift guys, I'm going to put as a 5:30 to 5:30 guy, so that way he's on the road already whenever shift change comes. So that way the road is still covered. So he'll still be working 12 hours. He's just gonna come in a little earlier than some of the rest of them, so that way we have somebody on the road at all times. Because we had a little issue. And eventually, if we ever get to do day shift, that way that would be great. But right now, I'm trying to focus on our night shift, make sure all that's kind of covered. And then the 3 part-time people, you know, that's gonna kind of help try to cut down on some overtime, or if we have special events like with Ricky Westville thing coming up, that would have, you know, or with the Christmas parade that's coming up, we had some part-time guys, we put them in there. We had a little shortage when we was doing the homecoming parade, but we covered the best we could. I mean, we did a good job. It just, whenever Wendy's got put in down there, that kind of gave us a little bit more of a thing that we had to deal with. But I think, you know, getting some of these other people on, I think that would do great.
On the part-time patrolman,
yes, sir.
Would they be guaranteed the same amount of hours, or just
no,
be somebody
it's
from a
just
different
gonna pool? Be it's gonna be someone from a different police department that's already certified. If we need them, we will call them in, just like the dispatchers.
Okay.
If we need them, we'll call them in. And we realize the reason why I'm asking for 3 is because we realize, like with our guys, if they work part-time, Rainsville comes first. If you're at your part-time job and we call you, I expect you to come in. And that's what the courtesy that I will have to show these other people that are working part-time, their full-time job comes first. And who knows, maybe at some point in time, they may like Rainsville enough. If we ever have a full-time job come open, they may want to, if they work out well, they may want to come here. You know, it gives us an opportunity to do a part-time like that, to decide, are they a good fit for Rainsville? And if so, we'll know it when we have positions come open. And like I said, that's the same with the part-time dispatchers. You know, it's not a set amount of hours that they're going to get. It's if we need you, we'll call you in.
Understood.
And go from there. And like on, say if we get bad weather, dispatchers real crazy whenever bad weather comes, tornado type weather. We can call a part-time person in, and then they can help relieve some of the stress on the dispatchers while they're dealing with that. So that's just kind of the way that I'm looking forward and going with all this.
Do you have the job postings ready?
Do not have them ready yet. I mean, Ms. Kelly talked about some this week. We need to figure out, do y'all want a lengthy work one that's going to cost a lot of money to put in the paper, or y'all want something kind of short and sweet?
The job posting is not put in the paper. If refers back to our website. It's way too expensive for us to do that.
Okay.
So if it says there's an opening, what the opening is, and refers it back to our website, so it's one line.
Okay, because I was under the assumption that it
went
to the paper.
No.
We've done that.
No.
Oh.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay.
No. That.
It was cost like $1,600.
Right. I mean, it's going to kind of talk a little bit about that, how lengthy of it needs to be, and because I was under the assumption that it was actually posted
on our website.
Okay.
Yeah, that's always been the case. There's just a misunderstanding at City Hall.
Me and Miss Gill can get on that.
I want to say that I've got job descriptions that were sent to me prior from the police department that I can send to you if you don't have them. If you don't know where they're
I'm going to have to get with the chief. He's supposed to, man, she talked a little bit today. We talked a little bit today. He's going to try to come in some. This coming week, he said he might, and help me get some things, you know, that we've got to get into the state to close out the year. So I'll try to get with him, see if he can get me those as well. Which I don't know if I can bring it up now, if I need to bring it up later, but me and him have talked about
the police department with getting some renovations done. He said he'd talk to you about that. And it was supposed to come sometime after October, so maybe sit down and talk to you about that, figure out where we stand on that.
Yeah, it seems like a lot of our city buildings are falling apart right now. But there are some areas that we have to address because it's making basement worse.
So like I said, I talked to him a little bit about that thing. He said if you were the one that he'd talked to, that Tommy had the estimates and stuff like that, but I didn't know where we stood on that just yet. So I just want to touch base on that.
All right, I'll get with you.
We usually sponsor, do a corporate sponsor for the Children's Advocacy Center, and so I'll have that to bring up tonight. We usually do a $1,000 sponsorship for them, so we'll wait tonight. I got this in the mail, and this is not on my agenda, but I'm going to bring it up anyway, if it's okay. Freedom Fest comes up the last Saturday in June. The fireworks company sent me a contract. If we go ahead and sign this now and pay our part of it, then it saves us. They don't tell me how much it saves, but their prices are going up a bunch this year. They're having trouble getting fireworks. They have to order them way ahead of time. We've got to let them know a lot earlier this year than we did last year. So that's just the contract and how much it is. And it's, you know, of course, we don't pay the whole amount anyway. Farmers pay half of it, so that's all.
What's the savings?
I don't know what the savings. He didn't put the savings. He just said it was going up a pretty good percentage, is what he told me. And I can try to find out. This has got to be done by December 31st.
Now, how long have we used them?
Huh?
How long have we used them?
The same company. Probably about 6 years.
So?
Yeah. Might have been a little bit longer. And they've helped their price. This is actually, this is about $1,000 or so higher, not hardly $1,000 higher than it was last year. But he says it's going up a bunch because they can't get fireworks. There's only just a few places that they get them now, so it's getting harder to get. Mental retardation board, reappointing Jonathan Phillips to it. We're bringing that up. And just had just some thoughts about this, and we don't have to do it now, but I thought it was probably getting close to time to think about posting the chief's job. If Chief Sanders is not coming back, if he's not, I hadn't got to talk to him later. If he's not coming back, then we probably need to post it, you know, sometime in the near future. If we do it now, it'd be about the 1st of January before we get to do it anyway. We'd have to wait to a couple of weeks. So that's just my thoughts on it.
If you do that, set them up for January. Mm-hmm. You want to bring it up the way to do it?
Yeah, maybe, you know, start taking applications tomorrow. Let it run for 2 weeks? They run for 2 weeks, and then we can start interviewing, you know, in the process.
We're going to enter in the whole month of December.
Yeah, maybe run until January 1, whatever.
So you don't have to do internal and external.
Yeah, but I mean, you might as well put them both out there so you'll have it all. You might have to go back and do it again later. I mean, if you put it out there for both the internal and external. But you'll start with your internal people anyway, but you can get applications from both.
Sure.
And that's the same way with those jobs you was talking about a while ago, is if you post it, you know, you can go ahead and post both of them, but if you find somebody internally, you don't have to, interview those.
That's what he's saying, is we're not going to have anybody internal, because this is actually creating another job.
Yeah. And there's probably not anybody in the city that's qualified already that's employees except maybe Tommy.
Well, I mean, somebody internally, correct me if I'm wrong, somebody internally to apply for it, it's a lateral move. It's not, it would not be a step up.
Tommy would be more of a part-time, because he's already retired.
Because he's part-time.
So he's part-time.
But qualification-wise, he would be?
Yeah, he would be the forward guy to work on here right now. I spoke with Tommy a little bit.
Tommy, he couldn't.
Yeah, he would fall more on the part-time basis.
Yeah, because that's, I mean, he's in that part-time.
Yeah, yeah.
Position.
And me and him have discussed it already a little bit, and he is more looking for what he does good, and he just kind of help out with emergency areas and stuff like that, with Tommy on that.
The Agri Center had to buy a bunch of shavings, and this is the time of the year that they come up a little short on the money, and so I was just wanting to know if the city can handle that bill for them till they get, you know, their money comes in the first of the year, or what we're going to do on that. 58.49. $149.
And they make lots of money off the shavings.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is the thing. I mean, we do it pretty much about this time, this month, every year. Mm-hmm. It's something. It seems like. I don't have a problem with this.
And they got a bunch of money coming in January?
Well, they've got, anytime, all the time, every year, it's always the same thing in November, December. It's kind of slack times. They don't have events. You're competing against, basketball, football, college football, all that kind of stuff, and you're not going to have a lot of events that time of year. So it slows down this time of year. but anyway.
Does anybody have the dates on when Mr. West's bull bash?
8th and 9th.
January?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, with him bringing in the different contractors, there'll be a lot more usage of the barn out back.
It's the barn bit bull.
Yeah. So I'm pretty sure that's where a bulk of the revenue is generated, is through the lease of the barn and through the shavings.
All right.
All right. I got a resolution on passing that too. It's for surplusing 40 old snowflake Christmas lights, where we bought new merchandise and stuff, and we've got some that we can sell. So I'm going to be asking to do that. And then I wanted to discuss and see if y'all looked over the swimming pool renovation list and get y'all's opinions on it.
I think the pool's got to be renovated. I mean, that's just all there is to it. I mean, I'm in favor of spending a little extra and doing a splash area, like a cute pool.
When we discussed the bond, that was my thing. I thought that would be the biggest plus for us to be able to come out with it, to be able to do that. Because we talked about the splash pad first and everything that we're trying to do, it kept like it was just going wrong. And mm-hmm. by this right here, you could do it all at one time.
What's the timing on this? Because I'm thinking about that grant.
The timing is going to be pretty quick. We're going it's going to have to be, you're looking at to redo and everything that's there. I mean, the way it rains, and you're coming into the bad part of the year for stuff like that. So, I mean,
I don't really know.
I just think it needs to be pronto, because it ain't going to be time to open it.
The only person that I talked to that would even consider it is the company out of Birmingham and Huntsville, both in the same company. Everybody else I talked to said we're too busy. So I figured these guys are probably going to be too busy too.
Yeah.
I don't know when they would be able to start it after we do the bids on it and everything. But they really haven't said.
Well, once the shovel hits the ground, that's pretty much it for getting a grant.
Yeah.
So.
AMRV, I mean, it's not a lot of money, but it's free money.
Yeah.
So that's not necessarily true on that one. I'll check into that.
Just check into that or something, and hopefully by next meeting we can say yes or no.
Well, I mean, we have to move forward with the pool regardless. I just have to talk to Renona about how that would work out, because grant paperwork by July.
Well, I sort of echo the same sentiments that Mr. Holt said. I think that we probably do need to move forward with the renovations. If the city of Rainsville is going to maintain a city pool, then we need to take care of it. And it's
what that was leaking per year now is astronomical by what we paid.
And that's not doing anything good for the asphalt.
No.
Having that much water run over it in the city park. And I assume all that water basically runs into the...
goes into the park.
Yeah.
You follow the asphalt every time that you're at farmer's market, you look down there and just pick a trail where it's going.
But if you think about it, it's been, I know, 15 years or more since we did any renovation to the actual pool. You know, if you were going to hold off a year on renovating the inside of the pool house, there's where you could cut your savings if you didn't want to do it all. You know, but that place needs to be renovated on the inside.
That's my theory, though. Why we, like I said, we did the bond and we had this estimate beforehand. That's why if we're going to do it, I think we need to get it.
I'm good with moving forward with all of it, and then whatever we can scrap up on the side, because I mean this is what we planned for. So any extra would be good. But
I don't think the pool house has been any internal renovations since it was built in 71. I think it's been
we just painted and cleaned as best we could.
Because
if
you look, half the doors are missing.
Yeah, tile busted up. It needs it really bad.
Doors are already all closed.
I also think the splash pad may actually be more family friendly and attract more people to it during the summer. Because it's a little bit more fun for a toddler to play in splash pads than a kiddie pool.
And it's still a bargain to get in at $3 and have a lifeguard supervising.
That's all I've got.
I'm going to make a motion tonight. We've had kind of a back and forth on the sewer loan and the whole sewer project, and just in case we need some help in organizing that and getting restructured, because we don't need this to go on the path, to hire Pat Tate to just kind of help lead us through this, if that was necessary. And that's all I have.
I'll just draw your attention to the report that Alan provided. I appreciate him giving it to us each month. And that's all I have.
I have one item that was not on the agenda that Mr. Ricky Dobbins brought to my attention today. The steam pressure washer that the shop uses to clean the garbage trucks is broke again. according to Mr. Dobbins, it's already been broke and fixed three times this year, with each time the repairs costing somewhere in the neighborhood around $300. He said this one right here would also cost around $300 and probably wouldn't last long. So we have one of two options here. We can patch this one again. He went and got a quote from Northern Equipment for a new steam pressure washer. It would be a 30 amp, 230 volt, 5 horsepower motor. It has 2,750 pounds per square inch, and it goes through 2.5 gallons per minute. The cost on it is $2,359.99, and shipping and handling to get that delivered here would be $204.24. So I didn't add those up. That'd be a total of $2,564.23. I'll leave this up to the wisdom and discretion of the council how best forward to move with this right here and solicit any advice on this matter. give a quick update on the Shiloh Estate Road project. We have contracted the county to do some grinding and leveling and laying down a crushed granite with calcium carbonate product and packing that in. That project is still underway. However, the weather hasn't been very cooperative here recently, and so they should be back out there to finish this up on a timely basis. They are waiting for the weather to cooperate to continue with this. And I wanted to give a quick little timeline of the leachate project that's been ongoing at the wastewater treatment plant. And I'd like to thank a few of the individuals that was very pivotal in this becoming to fruition. First two individuals I'd like to thank is our wastewater treatment manager, Mr. Allen Steeple. Without this, it wouldn't be possible. And I invite Councilman Mr. Fred Bobo to come by today, because Mr. Bobo was the driving force in starting this leachate process. And without him, this too would not be possible. And so, gentlemen, I'd like to thank y'all both very much. In July, we had two council meetings, and James Payton attended both of those council meetings, and we discussed, and this is July 2013. The discussion began to expand on what these two gentlemen started to bring in even more revenue through this stream. James Payton from Ladd Environmental came and told us the renovations and upgrades that would be needed to take on all of the leachate. I had Miss Kelly print out the minutes from those meetings, and you can clearly see that Mr. Payton was here, and his recommendations were to upgrade facilities, and that the additional revenue from these increased leachate processing would more than pay for the upgrades that he proposed. In the October 21st, 2013 meeting, we took a vote to proceed with this project, and it was one that was passed with all in favor. We then moved on with the project. Let's see here. We made a few changes with the sewer department, and early this year, in January 20th, 2015, we announced that we had paid off the 1981 series bonds, revenue bonds, for the wastewater treatment plant. And we began the discussion of refinancing the 2005 Series A and B bonds that were taken out for some upgrades back in 2005. In the first meeting in February, we began the process of working with Raymond James, and we refinanced the bonds. And both of those two moves created some substantial savings with the sewer fund. And one reason I mention this is due to the fact that part of the proposal from Mr. Payton was us going through the USDA Rural Development Association to do a loan combined with a grant. And, of course, you know, grants from the federal government issued out based upon need. Well, on August the 5th of this year, we did receive a letter from the USDA Rural Development Association that we were awarded a loan for the full amount with no associated grant.
And the reasoning behind that was that they said that the city of Rainsville had the financial wherewithal to procure the funds from other means. Which is a nice pat on the back. I mean, I'd like to have the grant because that's free money. But that's their way of saying, hey, y'all have been very judicial with your cash flow. Y'all have managed your money very well, and that you have the ability to go otherwhere than just straight up borrow the money. Well, Mr. Payton's from Land Environmental told us that he thinks that he can appeal this decision and that we still have the possibility of getting a bond. And we did two things that were very pivotal. One, he made them aware that the proceeds that come from the sanitation department to the sewer department was a subsidy and not a revenue stream. And the other thing that was very pivotal is that the council went ahead and moved forward, fast-tracked the bridge bond, the $1.5 million bridge bond, and instead of just doing it for enough to cover just the cost of the bridges, we were had the vision that it would help us get a grant if we went ahead and tacked on some capital improvement projects, and that's exactly what we did. Now, I mention all that today because I'd like to announce that we were successful in the appeal process, and that we have received the largest grant of this current administration, and the USDA Rural Development has offered a $830,000 grant to go along with this leachate program. So I would like to give the council a big thank you also for having the wisdom and vision of seeing the bigger picture here and understand how all of this works together. Essentially, now,
the call you back.
Additional revenue projected from this leachate program will not only pay for the loan portion of this loan/grant, but will also cover the cost for the first 8 years of the bridge bond. So the capital improvements, as well as the upgrades to the infrastructure of the wastewater treatment plant, will all be revenue neutral. And so tonight I'm going to authorize that we accept, or I'm going to make a motion that we accept the loan of, it's a $1.9 million loan, or it's a $1.95 million loan from the USDA Rural Development at 2.65% annual interest, and the $830,000 grant that comes along with it for the sewer department, and authorize the mayor to sign the documentation with that grant/loan. And that will be all that I have for tonight.
This is on the recommendation of Thomas Ridgeway and the folks.
accept the low bid.
Motion by Ledbetter to accept the low bid, second by Lingerfeld, all in favor, say aye.
Oh, quick discussion, and it's like, this is, if I'm not mistaken, a 90% grant, 10% match.
So I don't want that.
I think that's right, because I think the total was like 25,000 or something like that.
Yeah, it's around 25,000, would be, you know, 10% of that, so.
And that will be paid for out of the fire fund, correct? Is that how it's usually now?
Yeah, it needs to be, and then if there's any excess, then it'll come out of the general.
The only consideration we give is debt service out of the fire fund.
Yeah, you just have to look at that and see if it's got enough money there to service the debts and all that, so. If it can be, then they need to take it out of it, if it can't.
Any more discussion?
Yeah.
Got a motion and second, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Got the recommendation to post for the full-time patrolman, the three part-time patrolmen, and the two part-time dispatchers.
I want to make the motion that we post all of them with the full-time patrol position, be exempt from the 7-day internal posting clause of the job posting ordinance.
I'll second that.
Motion by Graham, second by Lingerfeld, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Bobby.
I'll make a motion that we sponsor the Children's Advocacy Center for $1,000 sponsorship. It's like a corporate sponsor.
I second that.
Motion by Lingerfeld, second by Ledbetter, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Make a motion to reappoint Jonathan Phillips to the Milton Police Retardation Board.
I second it.
Motion by Lingerfeld, second by Freeman, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Make a motion to post the police chief's job for the
month of December?
Mm-hmm.
I second that.
Motion by Lingerfeld, second by Ledbetter, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
I just had a question. The hierarchy is not happening until February, is that correct?
What we had talked about when we were done is by the time we post this and it goes through the regular resolution, we can only start interviewing in January. So it's good timing.
Okay. I support it. About that time to do that.
Yeah.
I make a motion that we got the Agri Center.
Did that go through? I don't think that went through.
Okay, we did not.
We didn't.
We start. Okay, sorry.
He better than the farmer. Motion carries.
Okay.
You know.
Okay. All right. I thought it was more discussion before we got in. Make a motion to get the Agri Center $5,841 for paying for the shavings and.
I second that motion.
Motion by Lingerfeld, second by Graham, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
I will do a little bit more research on the fireworks before the next meeting. We'll have a short window before the 31st, so.
I'm fine with it.
Well, if you want to know what it would be going up, I'll try to find out. I'll wait for next month.
Right. Need to, make a recommendation on this too. We passed resolution 12-07-2015, which is surplusing 40 old Christmas snow flood bikes.
That's okay.
We got a motion to pass stated resolution, second by Mayor Phelan. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
And I was going to ask this too, are y'all ready to vote on the pool? And we'll try and say, I'm going to make a motion that we move forward the swimming pool renovation project out of the bond money.
Got a motion by Freeman, second by Ledbetter. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
And that's all I have, Mayor.
I make a motion we retain Pat Tate to assist with our sewer loan.
Second.
I had a question. Is there a contract?
No.
No, there's not. Well, we have to vote on it first, and then he has to bring the retainer letter.
This is in case we need him.
Mm-hmm. This is the loan.
Is this the regulated light?
This is a recommendation of the league.
I'm confused. It's not a... what kind of loan is it?
It's the USDA Rural Development Loan.
Similar to ag?
Well, it's the one that they sent you a letter, was it about a month ago? The grant and letters around.
Yeah, I've looked at the detail. I'm curious why the legal counsel is necessary. But, do we have a second?
A second.
Motion second, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
I make a motion that we authorize Ricky Dobbins to order a new steam pressure cleaner from Northern Equipment at a cost of $2,564.23.
Second. Motion by Graham, second by Holt. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
I make a motion that we accept the loan / credit from the USDA Rural Development for the sewer leachate upgrades at the $1.95 million for the loan. It's payable over 30 years at 2.65% and an $830,000. Grant and authorize the mayor to sign said paperwork.
Can you add a date when that needs to be signed, please? Because I think we're under a timeline here.
Signed as soon, well, can it be signed by Wednesday?
Just add the date into your
okay.
Motion, please.
Are you amending the motion?
Yes, I'll amend the motion to include a date. Today is the
7th,
so it'll be signed by December the 9th.
I second that.
I have a question. The amount, is that including the grant? I mean, or is the grant an addition to that?
The grant is an addition to that.
Okay.
Motion second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say no. Motion carries.
Make a motion that we pay the monthly bills as presented by the clerk.
I second that.
Motion to pay the monthly bills,